Hello, everybody. We are the Dice Stormers. You are watching Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition Hoard of the Dragon Queen. And we are playing this first module that we are still stuck on, the very first published adventure.
That doesn't help morale when you say still stuck on.
Like, not stuck. We're
enjoying it. We're savouring it like a fine wine.
We have been skipping through some bits of it, and but yes. What are we? We're level four?
Level four.
Okay. How old are we now,
That's
though?
Right. That's right. Years have passed.
I've got grey hairs. I never last time I played this game.
That's right.
You've got them sewn into your banner.
I do.
So we are are currently in a swamp. Ben, do we have some swampy sounds?
I can
sounds?
Do swamp.
I can make some if you want. If you
no,
Ben,
you.
Ben doesn't need Sirenscape to make. This side of the table versus Ben.
Who will win?
And we're going to be starting in the deep end, and we'll do a bit of a recap as we go along. But do you guys want to tell the people about our characters?
Tell the characters about our people.
Yeah, tell the characters about our people.
My gamer is really...
Miri is not happy to be in the swamp.
No, she would not be happy about the swamp.
A lovely dress. And she... Since Mari taught me what girding my loins are, she literally girds her loins, which means to tie up your skirt around your, kind of making a pair of pants out of it, when she kills things. She is...
And when she's tromping through the swamp.
When she's tromping through the swamp, which is getting all over her belly flats in a really majorly bad kind of way.
Is tromping a word?
Trumping?
Yeah.
Tramping? Was I going for tramping?
Yeah, I was just double checking.
No,
I think tramping...
We have no political opinions about tramping.
Yeah,
no,
Trump. So let's tramp, even if it is Trump. Let's just call it tramp.
Aren't they interchangeable?
I don't know. We'll edit that out later.
Yeah, fix that one in post.
She is a gorgeous 24-year-old human. She has, it says on my character sheet, that she has golden brown hair and piercing blue eyes. Her sister...
Ben wrote this when he was, 13.
My character's name is Miri. And the Anvil Crown sisters, Johnny, who's not here tonight, plays Bella, who's the not quite so good-looking twin.
Who's actually useful?
Yes, well, she's useful. I distract, and Bella nicks the stuff.
Yeah.
We're a crack team, as it were. And she's a bard. Miri is a bard, and she sings. She's a little distractible, impatient.
And she moisturises.
She does moisturise, and Bella certainly doesn't moisturise nearly enough, despite my advice.
All right. Good. John.
Hi, I'm John. So I'm playing Varys. Varys is a high elf, and he's a fighter. He is a prince who has left his kingdom because of his father's deeds. Of sleeping around with humans, and he's discovered that his father slept around with humans,
and has
gone off to in search of his father's children, of which all of these people are in some way related,
except for me.
Except well,
so my
you don't know.
Yeah, so your father slept with my mother, who also slept with her husband, who was a human. That's why I'm a human. Yeah. So my mother had a husband,
yeah,
a human husband, and had two children, Bella and Miri.
Yeah, so this
also your father slept with my mother, and thus one of my half-sisters is a halfling.
Yes.
Half-elf.
Halfling! An elf and a human go to bed while they make a halfling.
That's right.
So, yeah, that's pretty much all I need to say. He doesn't like filthy, dirty things, and here we are in a swamp as well.
He doesn't like anybody who isn't really an elf.
Is it racist in that way? Is that called racism in this world? Yeah, so racist.
Race, that's one of the things that fascinates me about D&D, is there actually is a thing called race. Unlike on Earth, where people just have different eye colour and things like that.
But are you racist if you hate everybody else equally?
Yes.
No, you're just a disappointment.
Yes.
One of the definitions, yeah, that's right, if you favour your own race for racial reasons, then it makes you racist as well, yeah.
Right.
Cool. Yeah, that is very true.
Yeah.
So I do favour my own.
That's right, yeah.
All right.
Yes.
Nathan.
Janda. Look, he's not the smartest tool in the kitchen. But the thing is, people speak of him. He's well known throughout the communities he goes to. good or bad. Either way, he's very, very well known. He is a hero of Kaas because at one point he actually killed three goblins that attacked the town.
Mm-hmm. Not bad for a zero level.
Yeah, no, it was very good. So he sat there and he had his 150-foot range longbow. They could have been attacking the town. They could have just been walking by. Either way, I killed them.
Well, they had heart attacks. Let's be honest.
I assure you they were goblins and not just slightly fuzzy human children.
Well, I did squint when I saw them, and yes. I did kill them. And I got a banner, a large, quite large, obnoxious banner that sits, that I carry around with me and I place in the ground every time I attack. Because I have an obnoxious range with my longbow. And so even at that range, you won't be able to really see where I'm shooting you from. But you'll know it was me because on the back of every single one of my arrows, I have a faint ribbon. So I know exactly who I killed, which sometimes backfires because they go on and say, who fires the arrows with the effing ribbons? And it backfires. But all in all, I'm really the leader of the group. I'm the eldest of the brothers. And yes.
That's sexist. So when you favour a gender over another gender for reasons that aren't, you know, rational or logical, that's sexist. Sorry, what were you saying?
Ageist.
Ageist?
He's ageist as well. Well, he just assumed that the leader had to be male because he said he's the eldest of the men.
No. You did, yeah. I'm not even sure you are, though.
No, I am. By far. I was
You're
born
human and
to
I'm male.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm the oldest because I've always looked after Murray's character and he was younger than me and therefore I'm the eldest, so
do you
I
stop,
lead.
Do you stop and take time to carefully ground your banner, you know, so it's upright when battle surprises you, or do you just lay it down?
No, it's got a bit of a spear thing at the end, so I just stab it in the ground. Sometimes it falls over, which actually draws my attention more than the actual attack.
That's true.
So, very much so. I think, all in all, I think I'm... my character thinks he's by far the oldest and the wisest and the most worthy of leading. And
despite the fact he thinks tools go in kitchens.
Yeah, and he also struggles because he's an archer who leads from the front.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And so all in all, I think he's by far the strongest character out of everyone in the group.
All right.
And I hope that he can lead your party soon.
Cute commercial.
So, yes. Well, we shall try to do that. If you enjoy this video, please like and comment and give us and subscribe.
Yeah, give us a smiley face for Jandar in the comments.
Definitely. Yeah, don't do that.
No. Let's see. Let's just see the love.
See how many smiley faces.
See where you go. All right.
You can also optionally say, "I really hate Jandar." Hate's a strong word. Perhaps loathe is better. I love Jandar. He's great.
Yeah.
By the way.
Just like my Pewdie and every other character you've killed of mine, Ben.
I love that you
I didn't
took
kill
the
Pewdie.
Blame for that.
Giant foot. Controlled by not me. Squish.
In what campaign was
Under
that?
The Gods.
Under the Gods.
Hidden City.
He was the
Hidden
best. City. He was the best war pony anybody
One
could
of our
ever
most popular
for.
Videos, ironically enough. The Death of Pewdie is gone. Yes.
All right.
Sorry, D&D.
D&D, so.
Focus.
Back to where we are. So we're in a swamp, which is going to make sticking your banner in the ground really interesting. And
we're not under attack yet, are we?
We're not under attack, no. But you are moving through the swamp, and as you strain to yank the canoe that you've stolen over yet another mound, you do get to thinking. And I'd like everybody to roll, please, a wisdom check, insight, if you have that as a skilled.
I think it's really accurate that I rolled an 8.
20!
19
plus
1. So, yes, it's rather apt as you desperately try to hitch your skirt up around your waist a little bit further and tear your foot out of the
mud.
When
your foot goes right down the mud and then you
and
the shoe every now and then
gets stuck in there. And there's a waft of swamp gas and mud that comes out. And you start to think, why am I here? And then you think, actually, why am I here? We understand how, what the Horde of the Dragon, we understand what the dragon cultists have done up until this point. The Cult of the Dragon have been raiding all of these towns and they've been assembling a treasure hoard that they're taking clearly to somewhere. Mm. And you followed that treasure hoard, you followed it to Kaas, and then you followed it, they loaded it on a wagon train.
I'm the hero of Kaas.
You are. And they loaded it on a wagon train and made north towards Waterdeep. Mm. And you understood that because clearly their base is in the north somewhere. But now, after Waterdeep, when you followed them, they took this very strange side trek into a swamp. Mm. And they stopped at a inn that was right beside the swamp. Mm-hmm. And all of the...
Why is there an inn next to the swamp?
It's a very low income inn.
It is
on the route, but the swamp has grown over the many years, and it's sort of, you know, the swamp has moved next to the...
Oh, that's nice.
...to the inn.
I remember I'm riding one of those big blue lizards.
That's right.
Water views, I think, is one of the...
You captured that lizard. So, now the treasure has been taken from an underground cave that's underneath the inn, along a corridor, and that has come out in the swamp, and now you're following this again through the middle of this swamp, and you're kind of thinking, why are they taking the treasure deep into a swamp that's so inaccessible? Mm. And that is your pondering as you breathe in these noxious gases.
What do you think about that, Ben? About your
so
character?
The boat, sorry, so let's just get this straight. Do we steal a boat and we're floating in the boat?
Yes, but...
We're canoodling.
Canoodling, but there is...
And we're having to
pull it over. You have to pull it over.
There's no clear path. We're sort of trying to follow... Are we following someone?
So the ranger is tracking?
Yeah, can I do a tracking roll?
By broken twigs and things like that?
No, actually, there are symbols that have seemed to be cut into the various trees. So there is a bit of a track roll in order to follow them. So give that a go.
This is where we fail, and then the rest of the adventure, we're just stuffed.
Okay, so what's that under? That's under...
Maybe this is one of those times you give him a bonus.
Survival? You ready for this?
No, I want to see him fail.
You ready for this? The hero of Kaas does not fail. 15,
yeah, I'll say that passes. All right.
So what you're saying...
Boom!
What you're saying, Jando, is you can see the symbols carved into the wood.
I see more like The Matrix when Neo when Neo has that moment where he just sees The Matrix.
What?
That's exactly what I do.
Right.
I kind of just...
Varys, what's he saying again?
I'm not in character, I'm talking at least 2 weeks ago.
Follow me!
This is just disgusting.
Do you know what the best part is? I'm like really eager. Like I'm incredibly
chipper.
Optimistic
right.
And chipper. And I think that's really rubbing the other two the wrong way.
I'm not heavy. Can't I just sit in the boat?
But the best part is every time I get really excited and run forward, I splash you with the... With the mud.
No.
I told you there's only room for one person in the boat.
Yeah, but you two awkwardly sitting there trying to hold up your little umbrellas.
So, Jenda, what you also sense with your 15 is a ways off in the distance, maybe a mile out.
Yep.
A campfire.
You should fire an arrow at it because you
can. I literally can fire an arrow at it.
You could probably do that.
What's my range? It's stupid range. It's
maybe like
300 yards.
No, 600 yards.
Are we ever gonna get there? Where are we going anyway?
I'm like,
what?
No. I go like this.
Don't touch
and
me.
And then just put it like this, just across the loop.
Then you got mud all over your fingers.
No. I go. There's a campfire up ahead. Quiet. We'll have to walk the rest of the way.
I can't see a camp.
Isn't it lucky that we have someone who is so adept at scouting ahead, who might be able to test to see whether we're walking into friend or foe?
You could do that?
I believe you have the skills.
Oh okay. Yes, I will do that. So I'll scout ahead on my own.
All right. Roll me a stealth.
This mud is quite moisturizing. Do you have a sound of like, what, a splash or something?
Hang on.
That you filmed in the bathroom.
Seven.
All right.
Jeez. I rolled a two.
This is where they roll ones.
the roll isn't great. Okay. You get a little bit closer.
What do I see? Like, do it? Because I can, at 600 feet, what do I see?
At 600 feet, you see a bunch of lizard men.
Okay.
They're all around a campfire. There's about five of them that you can see.
Mm-hmm.
And...
it's good because that's the same I can count on one hand.
Yeah.
That I need to put down
that's,
my...
That's right. Banner.
By the way, I'm the best stealth ever because I think that's appropriate. Carrying around a banner that's like 7 foot tall.
Yeah, he's stuck in the branches up ahead.
So, yeah. What would you like to do?
Okay. Well, how far are the guys away from me? Like the...
2 meters.
They're
awkwardly, they've been tied to be on the canoe the whole time.
That's right. They're 20, 30 yards behind you.
I'm trying to retrieve.
So I go like this. I turn around and go, I think I found someone.
All right.
Because that equals my role then, because, you know.
Okay.
That's something that my character would do that's stupid. But at 600 feet away, they probably can hear or see something, but I plant my thing down and I start getting my longbow. And I
start sinking like the mast in like Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah, keep having to pull it up a little bit. But then I get my longbow out and I go, okay, what do you think, brother, sister?
I come up from behind.
Yep.
What does he actually see?
Do we see it too if we arrive there too?
Towards you.
Oh.
Are they, when we join him, we can see them?
Yeah, you should roll perception.
I draw my
right. I can. I speak Draconic.
Right.
Is that the language that they speak? Because they're lizards and that's just stereotyping. They could speak
French. You should just...
what is this? Yeah.
You should just assume that. They're lizards, of course they're going to be speaking Draconic.
So... I'll say, thank goodness we've caught up to the Horde.
I snap and look at Varys and just go...
It's...
Oh, I start...
you speak Draconic.
I've spoken it before.
I've studied Draconic for so long.
Oh, I gesture.
I could never get the hang of their pronouns.
You speak it so beautifully.
You can roll.
Elves do have a far superior tongue agility.
Quiet, little brother. Let
dexterous
me pull this.
Tongues, we'd be known.
Sorry. What did they react? Yeah.
So they did react. As soon as you said that, their posture went from sort of an aggressive one to just standing up and sort of looking.
Get over here, I call out, and bring this canoe over to the fire.
You're going to make the movie canoe.
There's some discussion between several of them.
I was rotating out to this, like to flank a little bit, or at least to side.
Do I remember any of the other lizardmen that we've encountered before?
Who was the blue guy?
Because we had a whole great conversation with a whole bunch of them for a while.
Right.
Didn't we? Right in the very second adventure, wasn't
it? No, that was men, but they were all... but
there
were
some lizards with like
dragon
well,
cultists. Sure.
Yeah, dragon cultists. Yeah. And we just basically went through and spoke, and you just told them their life story. This is Mark.
That's
Mark's
right.
Growing up on a farm. He has 3 children.
That's right.
He's coming here for the work, and he's going to go back. And it's just like... Yeah. Do you want to kill it? We're like, no, we love Mark.
So I think it was Andrew, actually.
Andrew,
yes. Yeah.
So I don't know their names yet. So, well, quick, get over here.
All right. Yeah, so there's...
Do we still have the egg?
Yep.
So we've still got the egg on our...
I draw one of my dagger as well, in my left hand.
Would have kept... Because we kept the egg going.
Yep.
So we'd still have it. It hasn't hatched or anything.
Probably needs a more warmer climate, I would imagine. Like the fire, like a fire with a sacrificial human in the fire or something like that.
Yes, you don't know what it's going to take to hatch that egg.
So maybe I'm rotating out the side, so I'm going to be attacking from stealth.
Okay. They start to get a bit closer to you. There's one guy who's clearly kind of the leader, and he is directing them further and further and...
I do the gesture of that all the cultists do.
Oh, yes. What is that? No, it was...
I can't remember. But we did a lot, I thought. I have this memory of it.
Yes,
but...
it was something about... praise Tiamat.
Praise Tiamat.
Praise Tiamat.
That's right. Probably say, praise Tiamat. Get over here.
Yes. Okay.
Tiamat.
They return the gesture, whatever it is.
And,
and
also to you. For all those Anglicans out there.
And they start to do you do anything between now and when they get to you?
I start scraping the mud off my shoes.
So now I'm awkwardly out in the middle of the swamp.
Yeah.
That I don't know exists.
Yeah.
And I'm getting my arrows ready for no particular reason.
They come up to you and they say, we are not expecting, in Draconic, we are not expecting any more cultists to come.
And were you expecting the ambush that happened further up that dragged our people all the way halfway across the swamp, being chased by some of the guards?
We do not know. We do not know.
Oh, this. Stand away from me. You smell disgusting even over the stench of this swamp.
We are sorry. Could you make a charisma check for me, please?
I don't know if that was really charisma.
Oh,
I don't
know if it was charisma. Say. Charisma on its own.
I got 14.
Right.
Are you minus one charisma?
Yeah.
Are you?
Hello. I'm trying to play my character.
He bends low and apologizes for his stench and says, we have some food at our campsite, if you would like to come.
Oh, what kind of food is it?
Oh, some very nice victuals from the swamp.
Oh. Well, hurry up, bring the canoe. Right. As I walk towards the thing. And other two, come, hurry up. Stop hanging out in the swamp, Miri.
Very well, coming back.
And I, Gala, I'm coming.
All right, they bring you back to their campsite and they welcome you around. The food is awful. It's
fish. Do we have supplies?
Yeah, you've got some supplies.
I crack open whatever it is.
Your lemnous bread.
Yeah, whatever it is.
That's what everybody has, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll grab some of that bedding.
Yep.
And I'll just start wiping off the clothes. just to clean them up.
Yeah,
I'm going to to try and soak the bottoms of my skirts and wring them out.
All right.
Is there fresh water there?
Not really, no. No, they don't.
Sort of they have drinking water.
They don't need that sort of stuff. Yeah, they just drink they can filter the swamp.
Oh, well, sometimes there's bits of ponds where the sediment has sunk and the water's freshish, so I use that.
Yeah, you can do that. Also, you can dry some of your clothes. Mm-hmm. They've got a kind of an area above the muck of the swamp, and they've built a sort of a stone platform there where they've got their fire on top of that.
So Miri takes off the outer skirts and
How long does it look they've been stationed here for?
Very temporary. It looks like a
rush job?
Yeah, it's they're on their way to somewhere else. It's the end of the day. So
Miri's dress is actually as good as studded leather armour. So, so it's got a combination of thick padding and also reinforced leather panels in there and sort of disguised.
Yep.
Thanks for telling us.
It's kind of cool.
It is cool. It's also green, a lovely shade of green.
It was.
Is it?
It is not a lovely shade of green now.
Oh my gosh.
It's more of an algae kind of green. Yeah.
It's tragic.
Are there rips in it?
She has almost no mud in her hair though. Almost. Well, when I say almost, I mean mostly not mud. Well, okay.
You that's do realise that brown. You have this giant brown mud stain right across here.
I endeavoured not to be touched by him.
Oh no, it happened.
I leant back dexterously. Yeah. She's very dexterous, much more than you. Should we do an opposed roll?
Yeah.
Oh wow, player versus player.
And that's four now because I upped it and didn't go through.
All right.
Dex roll?
Yep.
You tell me what
Hang
you
on, got. Was she flat footed?
Well, yeah, were you expecting her?
Yes. A woman learns to expect uninvited
advances. Okay, first number?
10.
1. Second number? 5.
What?
15.
I got 10, so yes, you don't have mud smear on
that. I pull out my silken handkerchief.
Oh, jeez.
Thank you.
Younger brother, it's okay.
So how
That's
old...
That's right, I remember this, because this is really inappropriate.
How old are you, Varys?
Quite old, but young for an elf.
Well, obviously, very young for an elf. I mean, healthy.
I remember this. This was fun, wasn't it? That's right. Isn't it awkward we're in the middle? Maybe we should let them go to that side of the table.
A human has so few years to study interests.
It's true.
As I said, I've studied Draconic, but I've just never really got such a good hand on it. Your pronunciation was incredible.
It is hard being human, I imagine. I turn towards the...
Do we start singing camp songs?
Yeah, can you roll me a perception as well?
Yep.
Are we chatting? Yeah, we're chatting.
We'll just be chatting,
Perception, so that's 23.
Ooh.
I'm oblivious to that. I'll just be chatting away.
We're chatting.
While I'm perceiving, I'm also performing. And the performing is...
One.
That's why I'm so good at my perception. Because I really...
Because you're paying too much attention.
To perform with your voice? Or?
So yeah, singing with a one.
Mm-hmm. So the leader, as these two are chatting away in common, you notice that the leader is following their conversation. Like, he's reacting in ways where he's picking up on what they're saying, even though they're speaking in a language that none of the others seem to know.
Mm.
All right?
Okay.
I throw in elven phrases every now and then to try and look sophisticated.
Yeah.
If I hear that, I'm going to change to elven for the bigger words.
Yeah, I speak...
Just for the bigger, like, fancier words.
Yeah, I'm going to sing really loud.
Ostensibly, I speak elven, so...
Yeah.
Just as bad as I speak draconic.
Yeah. But not for most of it.
Yeah.
Oh.
Performance, 4, 5, really loud.
Okay.
What do you do as a performance?
Everybody knows me, and my name's Janda.
The guy comes over to you and says... Whoosh.
Everybody knows me around Jenna. Here are the cuss.
He goes over to you and he says the
what language?
In Draconic.
Okay.
The swamps are a dangerous place at the best of times. Can you please keep your friends quiet?
My pet quiet, did you say?
Your sibling.
How do you know we're siblings?
Well, no. What does he call you?
We were siblings?
He uses, subordinates.
Oh, yeah.
He just used the wrong word in Draconic.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Well, you know, perhaps your Draconic is not as well-developed as my own.
Yours.
Oh, you arrogant son. He's fantastic.
He's been speaking it all his life.
I admire
you. You have a slight slur when you say... Right,
Janda, shut your mouth.
My name is Janda. I like to play with horses.
Feel free to dunk him into the mud.
We may have to do that. Listen,
Excellent.
Your mission in Castle Neotar. God, I wish they hadn't used such strange names. Neotar.
Yeah, how does that come out in Draconic?
About the same.
Neotar?
Neotar.
I know Neotar.
Sorry?
Do I know Neotar? Has it been mentioned before?
No, it hasn't. I mean, you could do a history check. See if you know it.
Okay. I'll pretend to know whether I succeed or not.
Mm-hmm.
I'll keep you ready. I'll go.
Okay.
I got 15.
Yeah.
Took it off.
I got 15 too.
15?
Yeah.
And a natural one.
Natural one minus one. that's a good
I go.
Zero.
You get like a searing headache. You don't know.
I was like,
you access that part of your brain that you've never used before. Yeah. It really hurts.
Immediately fall unconscious.
Being
the blood moves up there.
I just got this. It starts with all my blood.
you're like 11 when you've used one of your powers.
Thank you. All right. Yeah. So you've both heard of Neotar.
No, I haven't. I pretend.
Oh, you pretend. Okay.
Of course you do.
About all that you know is that it was a castle on the Sword Coast, and it was built by a half-elf wizard, and it was right on the edge of this swamp, and the swamp has encroached all around it, and the wizard abandoned the castle because he didn't like the swamp.
Yeah, upkeep would have been terrible.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. So
location, location, location.
Exactly, yeah.
And then after that, it lay abandoned for many years, and then it was adopted by
a necromancer.
No,
hang on,
Lord of the Rings.
A dragon.
Sorry,
it was a group of astrologers, believe it or not, called the Farseers of Elusk.
Was this because there was no light pollution around because the swamp had been around?
Exactly. Yeah.
Astronomers, astrologers. Didn't you say
astronomers?
Oh, you said
astrologers.
It is astrologers. My bad. Astrologers. Aww. Yeah,
we like not to make a distinction between astrology and astronomy.
We're not race.
Jobbists.
Uh-huh. All right. So yeah, that's about.
So what did he say? What was his? What did he say?
He was. What is your business?
Point
to the egg. It's in the canoe with us.
Do you, no, because they don't know that we've got the egg, do they?
It's a dragon egg. I'm pretty sure it'd be big.
How big is the dragon egg? They're like this big, aren't they? Like from Game of Thrones.
Mm. Yeah, a little bit bigger than Game of Thrones. Yeah, you certainly don't have
D&D came up with it first.
You had a
yeah, we would have covered it up.
Capsule thing that you had it in.
Oh yeah. So there. Why are we
going? It's not strung from your banner, is it?
I actually have a big helmet this morning. You're like worshipping.
No, go attached to his helmet.
Yeah.
I want to hear what your reason for going to Castle Numenor is.
Numenor.
What business is it of yours, lizard man? How dare you?
He acquiesces and says,
dare you even question me? What's the name of the big dragon again? Who was the name of the general guy who was a dragonborn?
Zentramin?
The blue
guy. Who we didn't kill.
What was his name? Nope.
I stand sort of in what...
Langdendros or Sianrath.
I'm standing...
Sianrath, is that his name?
Yeah.
In what I'm hoping is an intimidating sort of supportive statue next to him.
Yep, okay.
How dare you question Sianrath?
You say with
Sianrath's orders. When he sends us out, it is our business, and our business alone, not some filthy lizardman.
Oh, I did not mean to insult. I am profoundly
apologetic. Cut your hand off.
Snapjaw only wishes to help you in your mission.
Snapjaw. We have been waylaid by rangers that have been moving throughout the swamp. They move closer towards here, and your party was just sitting there by the fire.
Well, we are only on a scouting mission for food and supplies.
Look like you've escaped from your duty, according to my perception.
One.
I'm not very intimidating. 11.
No, he looks.
I look a bit silly because I'm just in my leg.
In your leggings.
Bloomers,
and
yeah.
You're also not the boss.
Yeah, that's right.
No, he doesn't really pay much attention to you. And he gives you a look up and down and then sort of turns his attention back to Varys.
But I tell you what, I will show you something of our mission if you promise to keep it as quiet as possible.
He turns around to the other four and says... Guard. They all sort of turn their backs on him and start to position themselves out in the swamp.
This has all been in common.
No,
this conversation. Draconic. No, that was Draconic. Yeah.
Draconic.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which I can understand mostly.
He's clearly picking up on some common that you've been saying. So.
That's right.
Oh, so we perceive that?
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. I look around and I say, the eggs are close to hatching.
And I quickly say in Elvish, I say, do you think, Sings, we can really trust these? That's how good my Elvish is.
He doesn't seem to glom anything of what you're saying.
Of course not.
You say that in Elvish.
These are idiotic lizard people with no brains.
You say that in Elvish,
Their brains are probably in their big toes.
I go, yes.
And what did you understand of that? Brain,
I got
toe.
That's right, yeah.
I said, the days of the dragon are drawing closer.
Yes, yes they are. Which is why we can't understand why there is this pact with the Bullywugs.
Bullywugs, that's a made up word if ever I heard.
Bullywugs are those, they're swamp people, they're cool. I have lots and lots of Bullywug miniatures.
And you didn't bring them?
No.
How do you not have them on you at all times?
We
Do I know what a Bullywug is? Because I'd like to know, see a picture of one.
Little swampy frog things.
Hang on.
Oh, yeah.
I've got miniatures of them going.
Yeah.
And it's great if you arrange them right there. It's like they're high-fiving each other.
High-five? Yeah.
Hey.
What was that game that was like a spin-off of Battletoads? That's right. Of course I don't understand that either.
Tell me some more details.
I guess they're reptiles. We obviously were not there when the Alliance was struck. We have been out trying to confuse the rangers out in the swamp, attacking where we have been.
I get bored trying to understand because it's hard work. Go back to my armor.
All right.
Tell me of this new news. Why?
And rotate it so it dries on the other side as well.
We had.
So glad you're keeping us up to date on the, your clothing and drying patterns.
The bullywugs in a cowardly attack.
Bullywugs.
In a cowardly attack, killed our leader.
What?
As a result, we had no one to kind of guide us in the negotiations, and they usurped our position as the defense forces at the castle.
I pull out my sword and slam it into the ground, like straight into the ground. I go,
right.
They will step back.
He jumps.
They would dare usurp those who are born of the dragon?
This is our thinking too. But we have no one to lead us, no one to destroy the Bullywug's central power. They have a shaman at their head, a man with great power, a Bullywug with great power.
This cannot be right. This isn't what the dragon demands.
Yes.
Different game.
Meanwhile, you're not understanding a single word of it.
I'm just...
You can sidle over to Ben and you can go, what's he saying?
I don't know. Something about bullywogs. It might be the word for tea towels.
Hang on, bullywogs, would that be the same in Draconic as it is? It's one of those words that, you know...
No, because Draconic is all...
Yeah, maybe not.
What do your wise men... What do your wise lizards say of this arrangement?
Your shamans.
Your shamans. Thank you.
I didn't hear that, but I'm just correcting you on a player basis, not a character basis.
Our shamans, we only have one. The rest were killed in the same attack. We are being given quite substantial gifts by one of the other people in the castle, an elf, like yourself. He has been helping us by giving us steel weapons, and he pulls out a steel short sword.
Do I notice the make of it? As in, does it look like it's a decent
obviously?
It's not great. It's pretty crude, but he sort of seems to indicate that that this is a great sort of prized thing. You would know that, you know, living in the swamp, it's very hard to create a forge and it's hard to mine for things, and so metal would be something that's a bit foreign.
What is his name or her name?
Which one is he?
There are many elves that move through the astral plane.
Born Grey, Drell Morer. Some of the names in this are just...
Can you just say that really fast?
Do you want me to spell it?
No, I don't know if it'll help.
Drallmorer.
So how do you say that?
Drallmorer.
So Born Grey.
Born Grey
is his first name.
Last name.
Oh, so Born Grey.
Yeah. Captain Born Grey.
Drallmorer.
Oh, can we see if we know who that is?
Yeah, sure.
What do we need for that?
Knowledge. You would probably have the best. You'd have like knowledge local, or because you know elves live for a long time.
Looking up to someone in any country.
I didn't pay attention.
Like any country and going, well, you know that. You're from that country. You should know the person.
No. Like... But if you go like this, if you say your last name...
It's like complete racism.
But if you say your last name is Lee, you have a much... You can kind of work out where the...
I guess.
But if you say the last name is Smith, then you don't go along and say, oh, you know.
Yeah,
so you can kind of get generalised.
Yeah, cool. So I don't have any kind of knowledge...
Like
of
a history, or a... Yeah?
Insight?
I only got 11.
You haven't really heard the name.
Yeah,
doesn't ring a bell.
I'm now repairing my armour with needle and thread.
Okay.
Did you tweak to it?
Can I just assume...
You rolled a 1.
I didn't pay attention either in the class where I should have been listening, or in fact now.
Yeah.
Are you rolling to fix your dress? Because I think it's definitely a roll-worthy thing to see if it gets better or worse.
It's just, I just take a 10. I think it's just something I do normally.
Yeah, I'm not going to make you roll against sewing.
All right. I attack the dress.
Yeah. Well, he sounds like somebody worth listening to.
He is, but he seems to favour the Bullywugs over us. I think only because...
He gives you gifts and yet...
I think only because he once the arrangement was in place before he arrived.
Is that how he said it?
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay. You've got to start that. I would never do that to you.
I come wandering over with a... No, I call out from where I am, sort of stitching away. I say, so the treasure hoard, did it make it to the castle, or they carried it further on? I never quite understood that part of the plan.
The spoils of the hoard go underneath the castle.
Oh,
that
yes.
is the realm of the Bullywigs, and That's we don't right. know what happens down there.
Can't wait to find
we would
out.
Like to.
This needs to change. Mm. This is unacceptable to the dragon that this yes. would happen. I may have been gone for a week, but...
I think someone needs to take charge.
He starts
take
to,
initiative,
He
even.
Starts to get very agitated, and he sort of... Like, he's squirming out of his own skin, and he's kind of doing this little dance, and he says, yes, yes, if you can kill their leader.
If I could kill their leader.
If.
It would bring you to your rightful place.
You would kill the rest.
Well, when we kill the leader.
I cannot abide these slimy frogs.
You haven't seen Varys fight. He's spectacular.
I can tell just by looking at him.
You should pull out your sword so you can see
I already have.
The...
It's stuck in the ground.
So, like, that's the right. gleaming, like, elven...
Oh, that's
root.
Right.
They're,
it's
like,
the...
they're, like, freaking...
It's the sword of destiny.
Yeah.
It is.
From
it
Crouching
is.
Tiger, Hidden Dragon.
Oh,
it's the green destiny.
It's green...
No, it's
It's a green blade, isn't it? It's...
Yeah. Yeah, it really is the best sword in the world.
This is the sword that you got after you chased the golden stag.
Oh, the golden stag, remember that? Yeah.
Mein Schatz hat grün so gern. To quote Goethe.
To quote...
No, oh, I forget who wrote it anyway. Schubert. Schubert, yes.
Thank you.
Fact check!
So I know that the song is written by Schubert, I just forget who the author is.
What's the song?
Mein Schatz hat grün so gern.
And what does that mean?
My lover likes green.
Uh-huh.
You will need to spread the word. Once we strike, we must have allies there.
He makes this kind of supplicating.
If the dragon is to be appeased, and your place is to take it, you would step into your rightful place. It must happen quickly. You will need to make contact with me again once I reach the castle.
Yes, I shall.
What is the name of your shame? Don't come.
Long tooth.
Oh, thank God.
It's not Herbinurba.
It's spelt with four P's.
Herbinurba. What's your name? Herbinurba.
Now, I must meditate and speak with the others about this.
We shall give you your space. Thank you.
I copy whatever action.
I do it as well.
Thanks.
That's right. It's just like...
Okay, I just...
Praise be to
him.
I wander over to...
I explain, yeah.
To Jandar, and I'm looking at his banner, and I'm standing there with my needle and thread, and I say, you do realise this bit is torn here? It's starting to say something quite rude, in fact. Would you like me to repair it for you?
I'm very desperate for it to be perfect, so
yeah.
I absolutely give it to you.
Yeah, I start working on his banner.
Do you take 10 or do you roll for it? That's the real question.
Well, it's unfamiliar fabric, so should I roll?
It's not just a piece of fabric, though. It's many pieces of fabric.
It's actually croquet. It's actually croquet.
You know when...
It's croquet.
You know that naive...
It's actually croquet.
That's right. You know that naive thing where you think you can do something so much better, especially...
Crochet. Croquet. It's croquet.
You know when you're my sort of character and you think... I can do so much a better job, so you sort of embark on it, and you discover sort of fairly quickly that you're actually making things worse. Should we see if that happens?
Sure. Well, are you saying you want to add a natural minus something to it?
Sort of through the naive arrogance of youthful
because you're,
enthusiasm.
Is
you're,
it an improvised needle?
Mm. No, it's a needle.
So you who mend your dress every night...
Mm.
Still want to, and have the skills of a person who's sewn for every day of her adult
yes.
life.
Yes.
Just because it's a different style of material, even though you deal with both cloth and leather and metal,
yeah.
all engraved into this one beautiful dress.
Yeah.
You struggle with what essentially is just a little bit of cloth. No,
okay, so I agree. I make it so much.
Right. But if you if you're not good enough, then no. Please roll. if she doesn't feel like she has the confidence to.
Many battles were fought, including the mending of the banner.
It's one of the patches on it.
All right, you mend the banner, and
happens, I guess, or be talking to the banner.
We should roll every 5 seconds on how it goes, like every stroke.
Because multiple rolls also
go. Crazy! Natural. All right.
I wasted it.
You did.
So they share their campfire with you. Is there anything else that you'd like to... You've brokered this kind of
agreement. I will try and get as much information about the castle layout, okay. Who's in the castle, diagrams of anything.
Yeah, where the Bullywood leader would be.
Yeah, so, mostly I will try and spin it in that direction, but I'll try and throw in a few info things.
The inside of the castle he really doesn't know much about. Mm-hmm. Prior to this upheaval, the lizard folk had the run of the castle, but the bullywigs got in control. The lizard folk.
Bullywigs?
Bullywugs?
Wugs?
Bullywugs.
Bullywugs. They're led by a shaman called Farblex Splattergoo. P H A R B L E X.
I think I can spell Splattergoo.
Yeah. We'll just call him Splattergoo for now on.
I believe that's his real... That's his given name, right?
That's right. And he is some kind of... It's like a
Lion King moment where they hold him up to school.
Just
knocked the microphone. Yeah. And they shall call him Barbleg Splattergoo.
So...
Stefania, baby,
you make the connection the name there.
Yeah. Yeah, totally.
So good.
So... he seems to have a lot of reverence when he talks about him because he is very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
He says he's a spellcaster and he's a shaman and he's a poison mixer and all these sorts of things. So he seems to be very fearful of this bullywug captain. Even though in a straight up fight, a lizard man would take apart a bullywug in any...
Is it bullywug or bullywug?
Bully.
Don't be mean.
B-U-L-L-Y.
Oh, B-U. Like bully.
Bullywug.
Wug with a U.
Oh, yeah. Wug.
Wug. I thought it was bullywug.
Thought it was bullywug. I'm getting confused.
So confused. Okay, cool. Excellent. We're good.
You remain consistent, that helps.
All right. The other thing that you notice, all of these... lizard men, they've all got necklaces.
Oh,
and the necklaces have things religious. That you would expect them to have, things like feathers and, maybe the odd ear of a kobold and things like that. But there's also weird trinkets thrown in, like pieces of mirror or small costume jewellery and things like that.
Can I speak to my brother just for a sec?
That's maybe something you can ask.
But you actually... You come to the same decision that it's probably religious or...
Yeah.
I wander over to one of them.
Yep.
Sort of slightly curvy-ishly.
Mm.
And playfully...
Curvaciously?
Curvaciously, even. Well, I imagine my path towards
curve.
Things.
Oh, yeah, cool, I got you.
That's right, yeah.
Well, it's more about the...
It's not
way
curvaceous.
No.
Okay. And sort of, just playfully...
we're on fire.
Look at one of their necklaces and
right.
Say, where did you get these... pretty things.
He stands up tall and, he's kind of fairly imposing when he does that because they usually sort of crouch down. But he stands up tall when he notices you making showing an interest in his necklace. And
my grammar's really bad, by the way.
Are you speaking in Draconic?
Draconic, yeah.
Where
do you get Kirby's things?
He speaks fairly quickly. He's obviously fairly proud of it. But you pick up Born Grey. And service in the swamp, something like that.
And does he hear?
Yeah, he's claiming it was a reward for some kind of patrolling that he did.
Cool.
Can we not? I go to my brother and go. Can we not give them some spiritual something to make them feel stronger when they fight?
Like that.
But like, elvish magic-ish stuff.
You say it in common?
That's all I speak.
Like what?
I go along.
Perhaps we should tear off a bit of your banner and add that.
I go, shut up, brother, and like push him.
There's a shift amongst the lizard folk as they sense the aggression, and they stand up and.
He's my younger brother. I just treat him as a younger brother should be treated, you know.
Do I fall back in the mud?
No, well, you've got a.
How hard did you push? Oh, okay.
Okay, hands still go to short swords and things. Like that.
I draw it out.
Right. Your sword, or...?
No, I draw at the moment.
Oh, okay.
Attention, for the lizardman's sake.
Yeah.
I look over, and is there any mud on it?
Oh, yeah.
Is there already mud on it?
I just smeared it a bit on you. Oh, get off yourself.
I look over at the banner.
Standing pristine.
I just look over at it. It'd be a shame if anything were to happen to that. I say in Draconic.
Well, so the long and the short of it
is that we're going to start a war.
Is that we're going to.
It's on.
We attack the castle, but at the moment I'm exhausted, so.
I think we
I
sleep.
Don't know about any of you, or right. I'm going to rest.
And can you make a day, like, you know, on the third, you know, in 3 days' time, prepare your men so we can get enough to. You know what I mean? Like, let's plan it out. So we just say 3 days' time, and then we have to run with that. Well, you're the one that's leading it. You're the leader now.
Oh, I am the leader now, am I?
No, I'm the real leader.
Oh, because you're the older, even though you're younger than me.
No, I'm...
I grab a little bit of mud off the ground, flick it over at the banner.
I go like this, I just go along and just pick up his sword, which he's left in the ground. And just... Did you want this back?
This is like a twitch. Right, yeah.
Because I would have... If this handle felt... Oh,
I draw my sword a little.
Okay. The,
We shouldn't be doing this with the lizard men.
I walk over towards you and I say, I would be very careful about doing anything violent.
Right, and I go like this, and I throw the sword up as we would normally do, and you catch it.
Nice.
I go, till next time.
The tension kind of breaks,
I laugh. And break that tension.
I go home and start cleaning the sword.
I sigh.
And the
try and look for somewhere comfortable and clean.
All right. The Snapjaw sort of
clean. Clean.
Says to the other people, beds. And they go and they collect a selection of twigs and moss and lay it on top of the canoes and create you a bed.
Oh, that's nice.
Fantastic.
It's actually quite ingenious. The speed at which they do it is also fairly impressive. They're using their claws to collect the twigs and...
Useful little creatures, aren't they?
Yeah.
I don't say to them.
Quite ingenious.
Do you have a familiar?
No, I have a large drag.
It's got
a mount.
But you don't have a familiar?
No.
All right, cool. I'm just curious what else is in this swamp.
I'm just going to sleep.
I'm just going to say, perhaps while the rest of us are resting, a ranger would go and see what else is out there.
That's what a ranger would do, would it? Oh.
Nice.
I'm going to go and take first watch.
All right.
And I'm going to climb awkwardly the highest tree. carry my banner up.
So
I'm up in the top of this tree.
That has to have a roll.
Let's have a roll.
What's that, survival?
Survival.
Drops the banner and it spirals down and impales one of the lizardmen.
Yeah, athletics or acrobatics. Or
athletics, yeah.
Oh, natural 20! You do it with a new teeth.
I just jump up on branches.
And you don't
actually
need to use your hands at all.
No, but
that hurts my brain. But that's so cool.
I just defy the laws of gravity. But the best part is that I kind of get up there as if everybody could do that. You know what I mean? Like it's normally that easy.
It looks like it Yeah, no skill required.
Like a cat climbing the tree confidently. Like, yeah. Coming down, baby. We need another roll.
Second
for that.
Roll.
So the you get up to the top and
then I do a perception.
You see in the distance the castle, and
how many days canoeing?
It won't take you more than half a day to get there at this stage. The sunlight is hitting the top of the castle.
How far away is it away? Like 600 feet?
No.
20.
600 yards, I mean.
Yards.
But the setting sun is just hitting the top of the castle, of which there is a sort of a very round, strange structure with a slit in the middle of it.
Oh, like an astronomer.
Like an astronomer's
slit. Not the
astrologers.
But that's, I'm confused. I'm not the smartest, but then I'll go along and I'll when I come down in the morning, I'll tell the other guys that I saw that.
Okay. All right.
Can I do a knowledge and I want to know what that is?
Sure.
Pondering, you know, I'm a ponderer. So what's my knowledge? Knowledge.
Investigation or... Ooh, that's a pretty good roll.
Perception, though, is probably history, 14.
Yeah, minus one.
Insight is, what, 18?
Yeah, I mean, other than the fact that there are buildings built by specific types of wizards and knowledge and people in the know, you don't really know much more about it, what they would do inside that specific type of
building. But I'm really interested in it.
It is very...
Well, I'm a very much a ponderer.
It's,
you know,
pretty.
Pull out the old pipe, smoke it, and just, you know, ponder what's happening in the world.
Yeah.
Not much to ponder about, you know. I've got three clogs working instead of a full set, so... But, you know, at least try.
In that toolbox in the kitchen.
That's right. All right,
not
well,
the sharpest tool in the kitchen.
Well, as you settle down for the night, I think we'll take a break there.
Fantastic. Just before we take a break, I have to take a fire and kill Snap. No.
From above.
Yeah.
While I sleep, not in my armor.
Yeah, you go like this. You wake up. And there's like a hole through your dress with an arrow on the other
side. With a banner.
With a small ribbon. Okay.
All right, I'll see you in a bit.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.